Good morning, Twin Flames, Star Seeds, brothers and sisters. This is the Twin Flame reading for the 13th of April to till the 27th of April. I want to introduce you my new bowl, the Maria Magdalena Rose Bowl. She carries the energy of Maria Magdalena, and she is getting in all the information I need, and I want to let you feel her healing energies and love during this reading. I also want to thank my new subscribers, and wow, thank you so much for the donations. I'm really appreciate this. There are some huge energies going on that will suppress this collective, as you know. That's why I want to suggest for Monday evening at 2200 hours to make a global meditation for love and compassion and to all the living beings in Syria, but also for Mother Earth on over the whole global planet. I got this activation and codes downloaded last night about the Astar Commander telling me, you know, there is this huge shield we're making to hold off the dark energies. And in the dark, our darkest times, we lit up the most and we learn the most and we see the light the most. So I want to suggest, and I hope you all will join us, you're in your own meditation, and make a shield of love, you know, so it can go all global over the world, but especially for the children and the people in Syria. So, and before I start, I want you to hear this lovely bowl giving your healing and opening your crown chakra. So, in the name of Mary Magdalene, I call in all the love energies and the high vibration. So, mote it be. Well, as it resonates through, and it probably will feel, you will feel it in your system and your crown chakra. I want to start the reading about the solar plexus for the divine masculine. He has this willpower, he's opening up his power and his solar plexus for more joy and more love to come in, and I will take a clarifier on that. And that's the Strife card. The clarifiers are the cards of Aleister Crowley, and it's like being strong in the middle of everything. And he's doing his best. He has a project in his mind, and that's concerning his divine feminine. He really wants to make the effort, and he wants to see how it will work out between them for the highest good of all. How does he sees her? He sees her like this energy of opening up her feelings and not being afraid of opening up the feelings. And she's blooming again, finding her energy, her strength. And he's seeing this totally different person in her. And he wants to do a lot for her, and he wants to come near her, and this project is strife, the also fighting for her, you know, within himself, knowing what he wants and what he feels, and go after it. And that's what the male energy is at the moment. And what's the feminine energy at the moment? The feminine energy is she is confronting her shadows, confronting what her pieces are within the relationship, and really honor it and acknowledging it. So this is really a breakthrough for both parties, if they want to look at their shadows. So she is helping the whole collective. She knows there's a shadow going on in the energies at the moment, but she also knows that if she goes through this gate, she will be eliminated by the power of the light and the power of the moon. So illuminated, yeah. She is going through that gate, and she's confronting her deepest shadows, but also for the collective, because she knows that in the darkest times the light will shine, and that gives the biggest power to change things. In the darkest times, there is also. Oh, I'll get something through. Okay, in the darkest times, there is also a flow and an insight that will see things more clearer. And if you go through it and you go through the gate, and you will come in another state of mind, and you see things more clearly for yourself and for other persons and the whole collective. She also knows that the template that she had in her life is totally changed. She knows the original blueprint she is received from the universe, and she changed her template, the old template from the old paradigm. So she's totally changing every time the templates of herself to get more light in, to carry more for the whole collective, to carry more light, to carry more power, to do the things she needs to do. And she also carries this energy for her twin flame. So she's going through this portal to solve things for her, but also for her twin flame. And how does she see him? She sees him like, okay, he's going more with the flow, taking things more as it comes. She feels the resistance of the mind, trying to go with this flow and try to leave the resistance of the mind behind. So, and more going through his heart, going, what does he feel? What do I feel? What is my purpose? What is is my life purpose here? And what can I do to make it better for me through all the shadow times that's going on at the moment? So he's taking it step by step and going with the flow. It's almost the same cards as she had last week. And this is funny because when I turn on the bowl, all these petals, flower petals, fell out. And they fell on two cards, reach out and giving and receiving. So what supports the divine masculine is the male energy is reach out. He has to reach out, to not to sit and stay steady and freeze, but has to reach out to his twin flame. He has to reach out to the love of his life that's in his heart. And not by sitting there and waiting, but reach the hand and come closer to her. Because if you sit and stay on this shelf, there is no possibility to grow. And I see that there is growth within the twin flame relationship. The twin flame relationship don't have to be always trouble or difficult, you know. A lot of people see a twin flame relationship as trouble, but it's also fun. It's abundance. It's sharing your light with someone. It's to get in a higher vibration. Of course, you will meet points for yourself that will trigger you, but then retreat, you know, and come together again and do your work. That's it. It's all about doing the work. So many people are just distracting and looking from the outside instead going inwards and looking for that light within themselves by connecting with the heart. What does the heart's desire is, you know? Through pain there is gain. So how is he seeing the relationship? He is seeing the relationship as giving and receiving. What you give, you get back. And he knows this. So he is more aware of the template of the law of attraction. So he will use this template of law of attraction. And he's seeing her light. He is seeing her light. So he gives because also I feel also out of guilt. But also out of love, you know. There is this thing that he wants the best for his twin flame. And He is able to give everything to her, but there needs to be spirituality, there needs to be heart connection, there needs to be standing in your own truth, authenticity, and in your own power, and speak your love and truth. And if you speak your love and truth, speak it with you know, with your own loving energy from your heart, and then you know that you receive exactly back what you give. So it's all about synchronicity, about tuning in with each other on the heart level. Both experienced pain, both experienced pieces of abandonment and rejection. But if you come over this piece of your own stuff, and you're going within and you did the work, then it will resolve in your heart chakra. Your heart chakra will be open and will be expanding to carry more love. And it's not only the love of the twin flame, it's the love for yourself, it's the love for the community, it's the love for the global, it's the love for Mother Earth, it's the global love of giving and receiving. You know, what you give to other people, you will receive it. And don't expect the outer world to change first. No, you have to change from within before the outer world will change with you. How does the what's the supporting the divine feminine? It's breathing. Just connecting with your source, your inner being, your inner light, and breathe. Just breathe through the pain. Breathe through the shadow side when you're going there. You know, not I don't want to say everybody's going to the shadow time, but we are in this shadow time and changing of templates all for 10 months now, and it's a heavy energy. So it's a lot of fighting between the dark and the light. But if you stay in your light and in a high vibration, and you take your rest, and you know, you take care of your body and your soul, then you will be in this light, and you will be in union with your twin flame in 5D, but also in 3D to come. And how does she see the relationship? She sees the relationship that as a project for dedicated effort. You know, they both make the effort here to come back to love. You know, they both want this loving energy and healing energy between them. But it takes work. And they had a lack of work in former relationships. So, and the relationship they really want to do and to be with, you know, in their hearts, they will find out what the sacred unity is. And she sees that he is coming near and he does the work, and that he wants to paint his world to see other people how he wants them to see him. So that's also what she sees, you know. If I feel at the collective and to the twin flame energy of the masculine, there's so much pain of war, of loss, of strife, of they're done with the battle. They're so tired of to fight the feminine or to fight out of fear. And that's what the divine feminine sees also. Let's see what his challenge is. His challenge is coming together. He wants to come together with his heart love, with the one he deeply loves in his heart. And it's I have the feeling some are still in a third party, some are in a third relationship, and I really want to review this. To review what's real, to review if it's just conveniency. And I feel he wants to come together in harmony and in his heart with his twin flame. And that's why he needs to reach out and give and receive. That's his mission, and that will be seen, you know. But it's not one way, you know. It's going to work both ways. If you need something from the Divine Feminine, ask her. And she's in this place of love, and you can ask her, and she will give it to you. If it's reasonable, of course. And that's, you know, it can be that she's not ready, or that she needs to have more time. But I know, I see here, and I know that there is a coming together. But it's a challenge for him, because how he needs to come out of it, what he's going to do about it, is love. He wants this union with his Divine Feminine, with his partner, without attachments, without conditioning, without dominance, just in love. And that's from the heart, you know. When you're coming together, this energy will flow. And I see in the overall energy, it's also his darkest fear. His darkest fear that she will leave him again. And that's the fear of the masculine, the fear of rejection and abandonment. But it's all also about communication. If you open up to each other and you put your love first instead of your own needs, and probably both partners did, you know, thinking about their own needs first, then you know for sure that there will be a separation. If you want unity and you want to come together, you have to come together and connect and put each other first. Always put each other first. Also with the children. You know, a lot of Divine Feminine concentrated on their children and on their work, because maybe it could be that they received from the male energy the feeling that they're not good enough, because they don't give an commitment or retreating, and in that state she tries, and she's going to work harder for his love. And that's just the opposite, you know. And he's retreating more and more. So the only thing that can connect, because they're probably thinking about themselves first instead of making a connection from the heart. You know, they in the beginning, go back to the beginning of your courting, of your marriage. You know, you do everything for her. You know, you even like to put the garbage outside for her, you know, and doing things for her because you wanted to make her happy. And when you start, or when both partners start to put their own needs first, you know, yeah, but she's not doing anything for me. And yeah, I have to concentrate up of the children, because they're my big love. They go first, you know. That's the huge mistake that people make. It's their partner needs to be first, and a lot of feminine are going to see this, and a lot of feminine are going to open their eyes for this, because, you know, your partner, your children need to come first. And if that's not the case, you better run out, because sooner or later, this relationship will totally fail. It could be because of the dynamics, and that's what What I see with the divine feminine, she has hard time to listen sometimes because she's stubborn, and she only listens to what is be said in a negative way and not in a positive way. And that's a human system, how we are programmed. So we have to change the template that we search for the positive things in a conversation and not to the negative things. But you can put your boundaries in that. But if you put your boundaries, also do it in love, you know. And divine feminine starts to see how everything develops. She takes her ownership for the relationship failing and running away and doing her own stuff. Because this runner and chaser energy, that's out of the question. That's gone by now because of the Maria Magdalena codes. And it's also about, you know, coming together, coming open, and face both fears and both heartaches, because it's time to heal both the feminine and the masculine. And what I see, if I go to listen, the divine feminine has to listen more to what her partner has to say. And acknowledge him here in love and understanding and meeting him instead of fighting him, because probably out of fear, you know. I see also she sets her boundaries. Oh, and there's some piece coming in over about narcissism, but I think that there's no narcissism. I think it's just unaware feelings and shadows that not worked through as a child. So I don't believe in narcissism anymore. I changed my total template on that. It's just unaware behavior of the divine masculine. And he knows that his woman is strong, and it's also for him to step up the plate, to step more in his malehood, because sometimes when the divine feminine takes everything out of his hands, without knowing, she demasculates him. She takes away his power, because then he knows, oh well, she does everything herself, so I'm not needed anymore. And that works vice versa. If he tells her, he gives her names, or I don't want to go in cursing or whatever. He tells her names, or telling her or giving her the feeling that she's not good enough. They both will retreat, and she will do what she's made for. You know, she will put the energy in the children. She becomes sick. She becomes emotional, withdrawn, and she starts to go and look for fun and pleasure outside of the relationship. And I don't mean right away men, but she will go and search for the soul kind people that she can connect with. And that's exactly what the male energy does. You know, he puts his energy in his work, work harder to prove himself he's man enough for her to support the family. But it's not needed. It's not needed if you come of a place of connection, of a place of love. You know, you're out of rapport with each other. You're out of system with each other, out of connection. And it's hard because you both needed to grow, both need to be separated, and both needed to be on their own for a while to find their own inner strength, because she has to feel like a feminine again, and he has to feel like a male again, and she has to empower herself with this beautiful goddess energy and with the Maria Magdalena love. And goddess is love, you know, and goddess is God, so they're always together. So are the twin flames. If you're not in 3D and you're in separation, you know, you can contact your twin flame in 5D. And you have this connection in 5D with each other, and it's your inner masculine. So if the man heals his inner feminine about mother, about his member, his family, his sister, his, you know, and if the divine feminine heals her masculine with the brothers and the fathers, so there will be more balance within their system, and just go with the flow, like he does now. She's going with the flow most of the time. What is supporting her in to get out of not listening to him? She has to go to this inner journey and heal herself, because there's healing possible at the moment. There's huge healing going on for the collective energies, and in these energies that is going on at the moment, and the healing begins, then there is a lot of things that need to address. And I see that the divine feminine also needs to confront her shadow side. And if that shadow side is confronted, then the healing starts, and then all energies will come together again. So this is the darkest. What is his side of the relationship where he is most afraid of? Is his darkest fear coming through, that she will connect or disconnect the relation again?
Just a moment.
And this energy for her is, she refused to see what's going on. She refused to see that she needs to be healed. She you know, that there is this healing, and she's also wearing this cap over her head, that she doesn't see the light, and she has to go outside to see the light. Sorry for the noise on the background. There is somebody in the house. So here is this divine feminine that really wants to do the, don't want to do the work. Some of them want to do the work, but they don't see that there is a light on the other side of the horizon. So it's just going inside and working with that. That's their overall energy. And I'm going to see the overall energy of this reading is about love, love bounds. When you're getting out of connection, when you're getting out of this connection with yourself, with your source, and going into the outer world, you know, the only thing that gives abundance, that gives you love, that gives you the giving and receiving, because everything is a mirror of yourself, you know. And that's what you send out. That's what you receive. And the only thing that's love, that's bounding. Love bounds, and be in love, and be in a state of love every time when you're going to some heavy emotions. So that's what I need to say for this time. And let's see what the Romans card angels say about this reading. Give each other time to know each other again, to start to know each other again. As you reveal your innermost selves to the other, your bond deepens. So if you reveal yourself, like with giving and receiving, and you're opening up to each other, then this connection can occur. If you just go from the ego and go from the mind, then there is this separation going on always, always. And this giving and receiving and getting to know each other, go and do this step by step. So, and for her, passion. Allow your heart and soul to sing with joy. So there is a lot of passion within her, in her system, in her light, in her love. And that she is really passionate about it, to give everything a second chance and to work through a new union. And that's what she does, because she's passionate about everything, and everything she does with love. So this was the reading for this day, this week. Come and subscribe. Give more if it resonates with you, you know, that's really great. Let me know below in the box how you feel about reading, what your experiences are. And I really like to know how you feel and where you're at in your twin flame journey with yourself and with your twin flame. There is a retreat coming up in the 19th and the 20th of May in Glastonbury. I'm also opening a B&B for retreats, private retreats through the land of Avalon, with karma healing, sound healing, going to the portals and rejuvenate. So you can come here for a healing journey and healing your divine masculine and divine feminine within yourselves. So also there are retreats to Avebury and tours to Avery and Dartmoor, Tintagel, if there's a possibility for you to do so. So contact me on www.shoshona.nl, so or the email that you find below. I also thank all my subscribers for the little donation they gave, you know, even if it's a little one. If you don't honor the little things, you're not worth of the big things. So I'm so grateful for all my viewers. And I love you all. And let me know how you're feeling. And see you next week. Bye-bye. Love and blessings.